Well, I'm Daniil, and welcome to the Emona Project. We here at the Emona Project are continuing in our series of videos with respect to inspiration, information, education, guidance, advice, and on the subject of Emona, I want to continue that the Jewish people are descendants of the great Maamin, Abraham, the patriarch, known for his faith, and we strive to be heirs to this gift of Emuna, so that we're truly worthy of the name Maminim Bnei Maminim, believers, sons, children of believers. For some, Emuna, faith, comes through intellectual contemplation, meditation, understanding the significance of faith and belief, attempting to justify and accept Hashem's decrees. They realize that in their limited ability, they can understand just so much. At this point, the true Emuna, true faith, is manifest. Then, there's the person who has Emuna Pshuta, simple, plain faith. Unembellished belief. He asks no questions, doesn't expect any answers, just believes wholeheartedly in the Creator, just completely and simply in Hashem. For some, it's the consequence of transcending questions and just have a simple belief that we understand. I'm reminded of a story showing that the simple and somehow unschooled Jew has this unshakable, steadfast, unwavering belief in God. Rav Yitzhak Silberstein tells the story of a man, a simple, unschooled person, could barely read, could barely sign his name. He heard the Rebbe in Shul explain the importance of offering the lechem haponim. These are the daily showbreads offering, and how it was important and how it was key. Now, the simple, uneducated Jew in his naivete failed to realize that this only applied during the times of the Beis Hamikdash, during the times of the Temple. So he proceeded to have two freshly baked bread brought to the shul and puts them on the side of the Aron Kodesh, or where the Torah scrolls are kept. Put them aside. In the evening, the shamish, the caretaker, the sexton, I believe it's called in a church, would come and he would take the two loaves of bread, because his family was very poor. And with the two small loaves of bread, he helped feed his family. Every day it would repeat. The poor unschooled Jew would leave two small loaves of bread for the lechem upon him. Every evening the shamish would take away the bread and feed his family. Everybody was happy. The simple, uneducated Jew was serving God, and the shamish's family had bread with which to eat. This went on for weeks, until the rabbi, he learned what was going on. He went to the poor, uneducated Jew, explained to him the halacha, the laws, that these only applied during the times of the Beis Hamikdash, during the times of the Temple. It was not proper for us to bring lechem upon him. These days, it's a halacha, it's a law that only applied when there's a temple. The simple Jew felt foolish, and he stopped. That night, in a dream, it was revealed to the rabbi that he should speak to his family, make arrangements, do a will. He was about to die. It had been decreed, a gezerah, a decree had gone out from heaven that he must leave this world because he had prevented that simple, honest, pure, uneducated Jew from offering the Lechem Epanim. Now, it's true that since the destruction of the temple, we were not allowed to do this. That was true, it was correct. But it's also true that since the destruction of the Beis HaMikdash, the Creator had not derived a greater nachas ruach, a spiritual satisfaction that he did when that simple, unschooled Jew offered those two little loaves of bread. He got such pride from that and such joy from that. This simple emunah, his simple faith, and this heartfelt offering offered daily, and it was carried directly to the Creator. Now, while the Rav was certainly correct in what he said, Tanakh says, we are to do what is right and good. What he did may have been right, but it certainly was not good. This simple Jew's faith went beyond the letter of the law. And the rabbi was to suffer the consequences. Needless to say, the rabbi did tshuva, he regretted, he repented, he told the Jew to please continue, that he had erred in trying to correct his ways. And he encouraged the Jew to continue as he had before. The decree was set aside. We're going to be doing more videos along these lines. Please come back. I hope you're finding them of some use, of some inspiration. And until next time, on behalf of the Emunah Project, I'm Daniel, and thank you too much.